हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, मैं ममता मित्तल, एजुकेशन डिपार्टमेंट हरियाणा। आज हम डिस्कस कर रहे हैं क्लास प्लस वन चैप्टर थर्मोडायनेमिक। सो व्हाट आर द टॉपिक इन दिस चैप्टर वी हैव टू डिस्कस आर हियर। फर्स्ट वन, कंसेप्ट ऑफ सिस्टम, सराउंडिंग, वर्क, हीट, एनर्जी, एक्सटेंसिव एंड इंटेंसिव प्रॉपर्टीज, फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक, इंटरनल एनर्जी, एंथैल्पी, हीट कैपेसिटी, हेसिस लॉ ऑफ कांस्टेंट हीट समेशन, डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ एंथैल्पी, एंट्रोपी गिव्स फ्री एनर्जी, सेकेंड लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक एंड थर्ड लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक।
लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द मीनिंग ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक। सो थर्मोडायनेमिक इज मेड अप ऑफ टू वर्ड, थर्मो प्लस डायनेमिक। थर्मो स्टैंड फॉर हीट, डायनेमिक स्टैंड फॉर चेंजेस। सो हीट चेंजेस आर डिस्कस्ड इन द टॉपिक ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक। तो व्हाट इज मेंट बाय थर्मोडायनेमिक? द ब्रांच ऑफ साइंस विच डील्स विद द हीट चेंजेस इन रिएक्शंस इज कॉल्ड एज थर्मोडायनेमिक। मीन्स वेदर द हीट एंटर द सिस्टम और लीव्स द सिस्टम, that changes is discussed in this topic. Then what is system? System is a part of universe which is under observation. How? Let's suppose this is a beaker and full of liquid. I am studying what type of heat changes in this beaker take place. That means this beaker is under observation. It means it acts as a system. And the remaining part of universe is called as surrounding. The part of universe excluding system is called as surrounding. Let's suppose I am studying thermodynamic in this room. That this room acts as system. And the remaining part of this universe is act as surrounding. It means universe is made up of system plus surrounding. System plus surrounding is known as universe. Next, how the system and surrounding separated from each other? That is answer. System and surrounding separated from each other with the help of boundary. Now boundaries are of different types. First one, it may be real or imaginary. On the basis of their actual presence or not, they are of two type, real and imaginary. Let's suppose this is made up of glass and we can actually touch it. It is actually exist. So it is called as real boundary. What at this place where the liquid and air are separated from each other, yeah, you can say where liquid and surrounding are separated from each other, there is not an actual boundary. Then this boundary is called as imaginary one. Similarly, on the basis of flexibility, boundary is of two type. That is, it may be rigid and flexible. Similarly, it allow heat to pass through it or not allow. On that basis, it is also of two type. One is known as conducting. Another name is diathermic. And second one is insulating or called as adiabatic. If it allows heat to pass through it, it is called as conducting one. If it is not allowed heat to pass through it, it is called as insulating one. So these are the three types of boundary. First category is real and imaginary. Second category is rigid and flexible. Third is conducting and insulating one. The basis of exchange of mass and heat system is of three types. We are now discuss the types of system on the basis of exchange of mass and heat. The types of system are three. One is open, closed and isolated. Open, closed and isolated are three type of system based upon mass and heat exchange. Let's suppose I have a glass containing hot water in it. Hot water. Its walls are conducting in nature. Now, as the surrounding temperature is low in comparison to the system, in comparison to the hot water, heat will move from the system into the surrounding. It means it exchange heat with the surrounding. Heat exchange with the surrounding. Water vapor from the hot water surface will move into the surrounding. It means mass is also exchanged with the surrounding. So, an open system exchange both heat and mass with the surrounding. Next is closed system. Let's suppose hot water is contained in a beaker which is closed from the surface. All the walls are conducting one. It means heat will also exchange in this system. Heat will move from system to the surrounding. But now the water vapor will not move into the surrounding. It will strike with the walls of the container and move back. They are not allowed to move outside. That means mass is not exchanged. The closed system is a system which allows heat to be exchanged with the surrounding, but mass is not allowed to be exchanged with the surrounding. Next is isolated system. Let hot water is present in a container whose walls are insulating, means which not allow heat to be exchanged with the surrounding. Walls, nature is insulating one or also called as adiabatic in nature. So in this case, neither heat nor mass exchange with the surrounding. Heat, mass not exchanged with the surrounding. So this is three type of system based upon heat and mass exchange. Next, on the basis of composition, system is of two types. One is known as homogeneous and second is known as heterogeneous in nature. Homogeneous and heterogeneous. If system has same composition throughout the system, that is known as a homogeneous system. Let's suppose I have a sugar mixture or also said as sugar solution. So it contains same amount of sugar at all the places in the container. It means it is homogeneous in nature. What about heterogeneous? Let's suppose I have water in this beaker and I add some sand into it. Even after stirring, you will see that at the bottom there is high concentration of the sand, while at the surface there is low concentration of the sand. It will not throughout the mixture have same composition. That type of system is called as heterogeneous system. We can also say that if there is throughout the system one phase is present, that is called homogeneous. If two or more than two phases are present, that is called as a heterogeneous system. Next, we discuss about the properties. As we have said in the introduction that we have discussed two type of properties. One is extensive and second is intensive one. Extensive property. And intensive properties. Now, extensive property means the properties which depends upon amount of matter present in the system. Are called as extensive properties. Let's suppose mass, volume, these properties depend how much quantity of matter present in the system. So these depend upon the mass or quantity of the system. So they are called as extensive properties. Intensive properties are opposite to that of extensive properties. The properties which not depend upon amount of matter present in system is called as intensive property. Like the temperature. Let's suppose I have a beaker containing hot water. If I put the thermometer here, the temperature will be same if I put thermometer at this place, because it does not depend upon mass of the system. Pressure is also remain same. It does not depend upon quantity of system. So temperature, pressure are intensive property, while the mass and volume are the extensive property. You can also say that one extensive property is divided by the another extensive property, we get intensive property. For example, density. Now density is intensive or extensive one. What do you suppose that? Let's see. It is equal to what? Mass over volume. Now mass is extensive, volume is also extensive, and we get density as intensive one. Why? Because extensive property, when divided with another extensive property, we get intensive property. Similarly, if we discuss about refractive index, so that is what intensive property because that is also not depend upon quantity of a system. Next we do two important term. One is known as state of system. Second is state variables. These two are interrelated terms. State of system means the condition of system which is described in terms of certain measurable property. It means any condition of the system is always described by some use of measurable properties like the temperature, pressure, volume. For example, a gas is said to be at STP. It means temperature is 0 degrees Celsius, pressure is 1 atmosphere. If these measurable properties have such value, then the gas is said to be at STP. This is state of the system. If we change these properties, state of the system is also changed. So, now it is clear to you, state of system is simply the condition of system when the measurable property has certain fixed value. Next is state variable. These measurable properties which we have discussed earlier like the temperature, pressure, volume are called to be the state variables. Why? Because when these properties change, the state of system also change. We can define state variable as the properties which describe the state of system. If any of these properties change, system is said to be in the different condition. Let I change the temperature 27 degrees Celsius and pressure let now 5 atmosphere. Is now gas said to be at STP? No, it is different state of gas. So the properties which describe a state of system are called as state variables. Next is important term state function. A physical quantity is said to be state function if its value depend only upon the state of system and does not depend upon the path by which this state has been attained. Let a person is standing at the fifth floor of the building. It must possess certain potential energy. Now the value of potential energy will not depend how the person reach at the fifth floor. Whether he use the stairs, whether he use the lift, it does not depend upon the path taken. It only depends what is the position where he is standing at the fifth floor or at the sixth floor. So, the potential energy is considered as a state function. It is state function because it only depends upon state. While work done by a person to reach at the fifth floor is not same in both the cases, that he uses stairs to reach at the fifth floor or use lift to reach at the fifth floor, work will be not same. It means work depend upon path taken. So it is not said as state function. Then what is the name of this one? It is said as path function. Means physical quantity is said to be path function when its value depend upon path taken to reach at given state. Similarly, heat is also a path function, while the energy एंट्रोपी, एंथैल्पी गिव्स फ्री एनर्जी, विच वी विल डिस्कस लेटर ऑन, आर आल्सो कंसीडर एज अ स्टेट फंक्शन. One more definition can be used to define state function, that a physical quantity is said to be state function when change in its value, depends only on the state of system and does not depend upon the path by which this state has been reached. For example, temperature, volume, pressure also state function because change in their value does not depend upon path. Let delta T, delta we use a term to show change in temperature, equal to T2 minus T1. It depend only on the initial and final state, not depend upon the path by which this temperature change. The system is heated or cooled down, it doesn't depend, it doesn't matter how this change occur, it depend only initial and final value. So this one is said as state function. Similarly, volume, pressure are also state function. So this is a very important term. Next we study about the thermodynamic process. A thermodynamic process is said to occur when system changes from one state to another. Means if the state variable, which you have studied earlier, when the state variables changes, state of system change. That stands for a thermodynamic process to occur. Next, thermodynamic process is of four type. Now study it carefully. First one is isothermal process, second isobaric, third isochoric, and last is adiabatic process. First study about the isothermal process. Let's suppose system is initially at pressure P1, volume V1 and temperature T1. Now some changes occur, because of that pressure become P2, volume become V2, but temperature remains same, initially T1 and finally be T1. It means change in temperature is zero. Temperature here remain constant. The process in which temperature remain constant, that is called as isothermal process. Next is isobaric process. To understand this, let's suppose initial variable is P1, T1 and V1. Because of some changes, pressure remains same, but temperature and volume changes. We are referring water. Pressure remains same while other variables get changed. The process during which pressure does not change, pressure remains same, that is pressure is constant. That process is called as isobaric process. In the isochoric process, let initial variable are P1, V1 and T1. We are taking similar case again and again. You know? After some changes, pressure become P2, but volume remains same and temperature also get change. Now here volume remains same. The process in which volume does not change, yeah, you can say volume remains same or constant, that process is called as isochoric process. Last and very important, that is adiabatic process. Let's suppose initial variables are P1, V1 and T1. Due to some changes, pressure become P2, volume become V2, temperature become T2. Now all these variables get changed. What? No heat enter the system or leaves the system. It means heat remain constant. The process in which heat, which is represented by the symbol Q, heat remain constant is called as adiabatic process. So this is our four type of processes: isothermal, isobaric, isochoric and adiabatic process. So these are very important and basic term of the chapter thermodynamic. You should keep in mind. Goodbye.